Psychedelic
Snack.
What we have in mind is breakfast in bed for 400,000.
It's a free concert from now on.
300,000 at Folk Rock Fair. Camp out in the sea of mud.
Maybe we can stop this.
Truly amazing, you're a whole city.
Dig it, dig it.
This is the largest group of people ever assembled in one place.
Hi, I'm Dave Herman. Welcome to the Psychedelic Snack. This is Woodstock Week, to remember the 19th anniversary of the granddaddy of rock festivals. And this time, we'll talk to the first performer at the three-day event.
Psychedelic Snack. On August 15th, 16th, and 17th, prepare yourself for three uncomplicated, unhurried days of peace and music. On Friday, August 15th, Joan Baez, Arlo Guthrie, Tim Hardin, Richie Havens, the Incredible String Band, Ravi Shankar, Sly and the Family Stone, Burt Summer, and Sweetwater. Saturday, Canned Heat, Creedence Clearwater, Grateful Dead, Keith Hartley, Janis Joplin, Jefferson Airplane, Mountain, Quill, Santana, and The Who. Sunday, The Band, Jeff Beck, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, Iron Butterfly, Joe Cocker, Crosby, Stills, and Nash, Jimi Hendrix, 10 Years After, and Johnny Winter.
Yep. That's me in 1969 announcing the Woodstock Festival to my listeners. And in just a few minutes, we'll talk to an artist who volunteered to sing first at the show after the original opening act couldn't make it. Right now, here's another group of volunteers, the Jefferson Airplane.
All right, friends, you have seen the heavy groups. Now you will see morning maniac music. Believe me, yeah. It's the new dawn. The Jefferson Airplane, who played from 7 to 9:30 on Sunday morning of the three-day event. Like a lot of the performers, Richie Havens was little more than a local hero in his hometown before he appeared at Woodstock.
Richie had been bouncing around the Greenwich Village clubs in New York, playing folk songs and drawing portraits of tourists in the street to add to his income. But after Woodstock, Richie became internationally known. On Friday night, Richie was the opening act on the bill, although that wasn't the original plan. Richie says they asked him to go first because of one simple fact. He traveled light.
It was already 3 hours late and many music getting on, and they didn't have anybody to go on. There really wasn't going to be any Woodstock, to tell you the truth. And if they couldn't get a band to that stage in the next hour and a half, they would have called the whole darn thing off. Because it was 3 hours late. There was no road to bring any of the instruments or the bands, and they had no way of knowing whether they could get helicopters or not for 3 hours. So it really was panic time back at the hotel 7 miles away where all of the entertainers were, and everybody's sitting in the field 7 miles from there with no road to get to them. Not a road to drive one piece of equipment there. So the helicopters was the only answer. And it started off with a small bubble helicopter. A kind of 3 or 4 seater, almost. And we managed to get 2 conga drums and 2 guitars and 3 of us and the driver in there, and they took us over first. Basically because we had the least equipment.
Freedom, 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 freedom.
That's Richie Havens, who went on first at the Woodstock show because the scheduled opening act, Sweetwater, was stuck in the 8-mile-long traffic jam. The Psychedelic Snack is produced by Sean McKay, assisted by Mark Schiffman, for Denny Somach Productions on the Westwood One Radio Network. I'm Dave Hermann.
Psychedelic.